Oh, hell no. How is this even a bathroom?
Hi, do you guys have an open mic tonight?
Yeah, we do. It's vocals only, and it's with our house band, Marty Omen.
Say that again.
It's vocals only, and it's with our house band, Marty Omen, so you can't bring instruments.
Bitch, what?
So I want you to notice how all the drums are the same in all of these hits. Cabrilla, lift for the night. Hear it? Right?
I do.
Every big hit song.
So it's like boom, clap, boom, yep. Clap. You could, I could faintly hear it, that's right.
Every big
just
song?
Yeah, it's just a slower tempo. Well, I guess we're using that.
Yeah.
So what percentage of songs?
Every like, if you want to do like a club dance song, that's what you do.
So basically, like, what is it? Bass, snare, or what is it?
Yeah.
Is that her?
Yeah. That's her. Same thing. They just took out the clap for certain parts. And most of them are like at 120 BPM.
Okay. Good place to start.
Yeah, most pop hits are around there. We can push it to 130.
So this is the kind of stuff that people would do when they go to the studio. What do they do when they're like, yo, I'm going to the studio?
It depends. Like, someone like, he's going to go there and he's going to pick through beats that he didn't make or steal them on fucking YouTube and then do his stupid ass bullshit singing on top. I don't know. I'd like to believe what I do is like what like the Pharrells do and the Kanye West do. If I may be so arrogant.
No, that's not arrogant at all.
McKinley kit. I made a drum kit when I was with McKinley. It's like the one I usually use. So what you have to trust me with, it's not going to sound like much for a while. Like, it's just going to be like...
Yeah, I know. You got to trust the process.
Yeah. So then I lock that in time. And I can play all this shit live for 3 songs. I mean, 3 minutes or whatever, but there's no fucking... I just copy and paste the shit because it's just saving time. So sometimes, like, I'll alternate, like, maybe it'll be a clap on the chorus, and then, like, during the verse, it'll be like, I'm gonna get better snare drums than that, but I'm gonna do the clap first. And so there's, so if you notice, like, the kick drum actually goes double the amount of times as the snare. The kick never stops.
Wait, no, I'm trying to hear. Oh, because it plays at the same time with the snare.
Exactly. And there's another way.
Both.
Yeah.
Boom, both, okay.
And there's another way you can do it with. But hear how that changes the whole feel? That's every other instead of. Just makes you march more. Each foot has a step.
I like it.
Wiki Wonderland.
Yeah, you can pretty much like sing a lot of shit to it.
This is called an open hi-hat. You know what the hi-hats are?
Yeah, it's the real high. Like, I don't know how to describe it. It sounds like they're hitting a cymbal with like little metal strings.
Yeah. This is. I'll show you what it looks like. These are the hi-hats, right here. Those of the drum kit. That's what a hi-hat is.
Oh, okay.
And when they're closed, when they're clamped shut, and you hit it with your drumsticks, sounds like that. And then if you open it up, but it's different than like
cymbal.
These are the crash cymbals. You know, okay. This is the ride cymbal. Jazz.
Okay.
But anyway, so something I just learned over the year, just an open hi-hat for club dance stuff. Just, now it's just, you basically want to create the foundation to where, like, yeah, the Discovery Channel, getting horny now. Isn't that what he says? Something like that.
Yeah.
So already you can now look like you can like. You can sing any of the pop songs to it. Ding 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 ding. Michael Jackson. Ding ding ding. Ding. Wicked Wonder. Wicky Wicky Wonderland. Bam bam bam. For night, I live for a night. See, it's already like, it's already, the foundation's already there. So now is where the most creative part comes, and the part that's most crucial is like I was talking about,
That created that interesting sound.
Yeah. First, I'm gonna add a live drum sound. So this is.
But like, so you'd eventually turn that beat down a little bit. Like, it depends what kind of song you're doing. But for instance, for Corella, they turn that beat down. Like, you can't hear the drums that loudly in comparison to everything else, right?
Let's see. This is a tough speaker to judge it on. But let's see. Welcome to the 2019. You don't even have to spell shit right, and the internet finds it. All right. Yeah, I mean, it's definitely balanced, turned down, but you can hear it, right?
But if you don't know music, you can't even know it's there, really.
Right. So I'm just gonna add a little extra, like.
Do they use a hi-hat or no?
Let's find out. But the hi-hat is something you'll hardly notice in the end. Sounds like this. There sounds like this.
How many layers do you think are in that song?
A nice amount. There sounds like this.
Okay.
So listen for this. Hear it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
So eventually, yeah.
It doesn't sound like a typical, like, rap, like, kind of like. Like, a lot of your songs, you do hip, you do the hi-hat a lot, and then other ones, I feel like you do both.
Yeah, if you're gonna do, like, beats from, like, North America have less hi-hat. Beats from, like, down south will have faster hi-hats. So depending on, like, what region of beat I'm choosing to make, like, if I'm gonna make a southern beat, a west coast beat, an east coast beat, that's, like, when the different types of hi-hats will come into play.
Okay.
So now we got that. So even right here, without overthinking, what are you naturally inspired if I was like, yeah, just whistle to this. Go ahead. That's cool.
I don't know.
So then we can do that and see. Don't focus on the sound yet. We're just gonna get the notes.
Am I supposed to know what type of song this is supposed to be, or do I just like go into it just like with whatever and just try to spit something that works?
Yeah, just keep going for whatever is inspiring you. Like whatever is making you.
I think I'd rather make like. Like a song more like make the same kind of style as Corella,
yeah,
than like a rap, because I definitely do not feel like I've earned that card yet to make a rap
song. Oh no, that's what I figured. We're doing like more of a party song. Yeah, right now this is definitely like Corella foundation. I'll show you. If it was gonna be a rap beat, the bass drum would change, so watch this. would probably be Mike.
Oh yeah, totally.
But look, the BPM didn't change. So the BPM can stay the same, and just by changing the pattern of the kick drum and the snare can really determine what genre it is. But back to our Corella. Like I said, this part is tough because it's like it's so repetitive, it's so empty right now, it's like it sounds like so boring.
No, I get it. You painted the picture well.
So then now I might just like cycle through different sounds and see if I like I kinda like that chord, but I don't know.
I'm just gonna
keep going.
Keep going.
Okay. Oh, that does sound funky though. I'm just gonna mark it for myself.
Okay. Does Logic come with like basically every sound you would ever need?
Not drums though. All my drums are custom. It and then mute it. Oh yeah, if I meet someone and I don't get the Caesar salad or rap or perform right on the spot. I mean, how many people say I'm the best? You know,
seriously,
like people are like, yeah, right. You know.
If you even hint to your music at all, I'll be like, Nappy, just fucking start rapping, and you start doing it before they even say anything, and just it's like you don't even give them a chance to say it, and then you're immediately in. It's like you almost mind fucked them. You know what I mean? It's like, oh man, they just took off and went, and now I like what I'm hearing.
Yeah, you're right.
Like when I say that, just be like before I even end, be like, Nappy, how about you rap or something? You know, before I end, be like, you're just like, you know, boom, we start.
I like the way you think. Run into like Jay-Z.
Yeah.
And you're like talking to him and you're like, oh yeah, and you know, yeah, thank you for your time, Caesar salad, and you know. Crenshaw. That would be Nipsey Hussle. You wanna hear some Crenshaw music?
Yeah. Oh yeah, yeah.
I fucking wish Alexa worked, man.
I know, right? Dude, can you see if you can, like, get her to play with it? I'm pretty sure if you Google it, if you ask it, can Alexa play on your phone if you have the app? I'm pretty sure it may, but, you know.
Nipsey Hussle from California. He's super famous now. I think he was nominated for a Grammy this year.
Okay.
He, was from Crenshaw. And, sold merchandise and stuff on the corner, and his people would get arrested and shit because like they didn't have a permit, and they were selling like t-shirts and stuff.
Like his merch?
Yeah, his merch. Flash forward, now at the same corner where they used to do that shit, they have a smart store. Super successful. It's like, as soon as you walk in, your phone and your bag become interactive and shit.
No way.
Yeah, he totally like worked from the bottom up. Were you getting hype?
Oh my god. Jesus Christ.
Oh man.
Jesus.
Where we at, baby? Yeah. W?
W. This place is fun in the summer.
Yeah? So we're at the W. Man, just watch someone on a bike get messed up. And now we're gonna meet them. Oh, hell no. How is this even a bathroom? God damn, we're in the W in Hollywood. Today was a day I had to do a lot of editing, so I didn't really get much done. And besides editing and practicing for my show, look at this bathroom. Upper Darby kids don't always get here. And I don't mean that disrespectfully, I only mean it inspiringly. You know, people make me feel like I'm from Upper Darby and I never see a bathroom like this. You can too. Don't matter where you're from. Damn, one more spin while there's no one in here. Never seen a bathroom like this. God damn, look at that safe.
So the people that started Dollar Shave Club started making man wipes. Like, I've never had to use a wipe in my life, so I don't quite understand what it's for. Does anybody in the car have an idea?
Man wipes the same as just a wet wipe.
A wipe? Like, okay, so I know that you guys here in the United States do not have that little thing that sprays your ass after you poo. So if you don't have the wipe, how sure are you that clean?
I agree. God.
That's the same issue that I have, like, with this Brazilian, like Brazilian.
The Amish people just get the hose and just spray.
No. Yeah, Brazilian, like we have like the water spray thing. But Brazilians just came up with this black toilet paper, and that bothers the shit out of me, people that uses them. Because how sure are you that you're clean? Because you don't get to see it, right?
It's black. Yeah, you're right. White is very judgmental, the asshole.
But still, Charles, can you bring me the soft one? It's just the best advertising for a toilet paper ever.
I want.
Isn't it, Charles?
The triple ply.
Very soft.
Very soft. That's what everybody wants.
It doesn't scratch your ass. For a second.
It doesn't scratch your ass. That was.
For a second.
That was pretty funny.
Bruh. I'm not joking about that. Cause like, have you seen those very cheap toilet papers?
Yeah, they scratch your ass.
No, but like,
they
now.
Do not scratch your ass. You can literally polish your nail on those. Not even, like, honestly. I feel offended when I get in a toilet that has those.
Really?
Of course, because you guys only get to wipe your ass. We have to wipe both things.
Yeah.
But isn't it kind of a one and done with the front?
No, you can't go back to front.
No! Money.